Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the final game, the Who Shall, the Big Daddy. The champion will be decided. Slovakia, defending champs. USA, first time to the dance.
First time at a medal for the USA.
My name is Steve Power. I'm joined by Chris Banks of Ashy Hockey. Big one here, United States undefeated in this tournament, looking to run the table. A rematch of their first round robin game where the U.S. came out on top by a score 4-3. A different Slovakian team right now though, Chris, but I tell you what, this U.S. team, the key to this game, in my opinion, is gonna be speed. What's your take on it?
That's exactly what it is. It's speed, all speed. The U.S. has moved as a unit as quickly as anybody has in this tournament with consistency. The Slovaks started the tournament out a little bit out of sorts, I think, would probably be the best term that we could use there.
Yep,
but
yep.
They certainly have come together when it was important, and that's the all the makings of a veteran team that knows how to win.
My only concern for the U.S. in this game, folks, is are they battle-tested?
Well,
Slovakia had to get through Canada in overtime. They had an all-out war last night with the Czech Republic. The United States, call a spade a spade, had a pretty easy time. But now that being said, I think they've had an easy time because they played so well.
Yeah, they kind of made it look easy.
Absolutely. So, battle today. Jonathan Rethich getting the call between the pipes for the Americans. And no surprise, Stanislav Petrík getting the call for Slovakia. Here's Boris Orvec, the ninja. First man on the ball here. Here's a drive from the point. Rethich, a little trouble with his equipment down there. Great job there. Goalie was actually fixing his shoulder pads.
This might not be the time for that, Jonathan.
You can reach out to us on Twitter, folks. We will try to catch up. Here's a chance, Slovakia. Shoot, scores! Slovakia on the partial breakaway. The Slovaks strike first. Trying to get a number there. Looks like it was Milan Benijec. And a good try there by Hackett, I believe. I thought Hackett had stolen the ball and stopped the breakaway, but Benijec strikes early for the Slovaks.
He's a world-class player, Steve. If you don't get him the first time, he's going to get you the second time.
So, folks, as I say, you can check in with me on Twitter, at StevePowerNL. Do our best to keep up with you, but the U.S. fans might actually break the internet here today. Lots of support coming to the U.S. team. In a little hole here now. Not the first time they've fallen behind in the tournament, Chris, is it?
No. But if you went into this game thinking you weren't getting scored on, you have some pretty lofty expectation levels.
Absolutely. So, ball in American territory. Mike Colcord gets a chance to move it out for U.S. Colcord, good run there. Finds Hackett. Hackett shoots, scores! Hackett catches Petrík cheating. I think Petrík was looking for the pass there, Chris. And Hackett just fired a short side. What an answer for the United States of America right away.
Well, if you're looking for an answer for Jess Hackett that didn't end up getting the Slovak player from behind, he just answered and said, I'm back in this game.
We're 140 in, 1-1, action at both ends. I'm telling you, George Scott, you better be nearby. You might have to tag in for this one, big guy, because I don't know if I'm going to last. What a start.
Wow.
From the draw, Slovakia gives pace, chasing their own end. The American stick goes flying. Slovaks chance to come away. Good back check pressure by the States. Ball outside, Americans have to clear the zone. Doherty doesn't see that. We'll have an offside call here. And the ball will come out the blue line just 2 minutes in. And Chris, what a crowd here for Slovakia. U.S., there's definitely close to 3,000 people here.
I think there's over 3,000 because there's more on our side that we can't see directly down here because we're above the player benches. But I would say there's gonna be more than that.
So face-off will come outside the American blue line on that delayed offside call. Tyler Cabba digs in for the States. Face off, won by the USA. Ball knifed deep in the zone. Here comes Petito. Petito back pass there. American player upended into crease. No call, play continues. Cava, good work on the wall there. And here's Hildreth. Hildreth shot, that one's deflected. And Petrick had to be careful with that. Roman Budak now for Slovakia. Budak, cross floor pass, finds the stick of Kolar. Kolar, ball out for Echker. Echker can't hold on to that one. Just dumps it in deep for Rampacek. Rampacek, here's Ivan Rampacek for Slovakia. Rampacek down below the goal line, moves it out. The Slovaks now, good job of ball possession, but being kept to the outside by the States. Here's Rampacek. Rampacek can't get away from the American defenseman on that play. And we see the big line on the floor here for the States. Bobby Hauser just starting the line change. Key to this game for the Slovaks, Chris, no doubt going to be stopping the line of Bobby Hauser, Denny Schlegel, and Johnny Ruiz.
That's a that's a line that not many have been able to stop. Bobby and Denny are right up there with the league leaders. I believe Denny might be in the lead. Bob not too far behind. Going to be a tough battle for them.
Not many been able to stop. Nobody been able to stop.
I was being kind.
You were being very nice. At Steve Power and L, I call it like I see it, folks. You might not like it, you might love it, but here it comes. Get ready. Slovakia, chance in the slot. Rethich had to be careful with that one. And the American players fired into the bench area early in this first period. Both teams trading quality scoring chances. And the emotion here, the building, maybe it was from the other North American to the north of you, your cousins to the north, winning the women's goal, but it seems like the intensity is just ratcheted up in this building.
You can absolutely feel it. If anybody's been, now I'm certainly not going to compare this to an NHL playoff game, based on the amount of people, but if you know what I'm talking about when you say energy.
I think that's a fair assessment,
Chris. It's all over the place here.
And looking at, I know I was happened to be down in the tunnel when the American players were coming out for warm-up, and boy, you could tell they were ready to go. And Slovakia, such a proud ball hockey nation, defending champs after going through the war to get here, and the Slovaks, you know, will be ready. Schlegel has the ball roll off his stick down low. Here's Schlegel behind the net. Schlegel throws one there, looking for Wilson. Gloved ahead by the Slovak player. Tries to get out of the zone, but Wilson will have a chance to take over for the Americans. Wilson gonna hold on down low. Leaves it for Hauser. Hauser, that ball gets poke checked off his stick. And Slovakia with a chance to come away. Danko behind the net. Here's Danko. Americans get a full line change in. Keep the pressure on as Steve Gregory does a great job pressuring the ball. Back for Danko now. Danko, he leaves it back behind the net. Slovakia trying to slow this game down. There's a turnover by Gregory. Fantastic forecheck by Gregory. Shot right on, rebound on the short side, and Petrick has the hold on to that one. Great forechecking by the Americans early on.
Well, if you're gonna beat the Americans, if they've proven anything all week long, is that you're not gonna beat them by standing around. So if you keep doing what they were doing right there, there's gonna be a face-off at center ice, like I say, and it's not gonna be after the period.
Amy Iwant loves the goal by number 89. Ryan checking in, looking for Corey Wilson to score a goal. Jay Mullen checking in, asking me, who am I picking, USA or Slovakia? Oh my goodness. Uh-oh. I might have to plant myself firmly on the fence for the first 10 minutes here. The U.S. have come through, but I really like Slovakia lately. I'll tell you what, ask me again after the first. I know that's probably a politically correct answer, but ask me after the first.
You don't have to ask me. You already know what I'm going to say.
Oh, obviously. Someone asked me that the other day, Chris. They said, who do you think is going to win, Slovakia or Canada? Obviously, I'm going to say Canada. Even if I don't think they're going to win, I'm going to say Canada.
Right.
So you're in the same boat.
Oh, yeah.
Although I truly do believe, in your heart of hearts, you believe it's going to be the U.S.
I do.
You have no reason to think otherwise.
No, and it's been the year of preparation that these guys put in. And I just feel it.
And it's really good to hear about the preparation the U.S. team does, because we know, and I can tell just by the crew of coaches around me, two video cameras, video coach, Slovakian ball hockey president Joseph Stumpel here to my left. Slovakian ball hockey, a real big deal in that country.
Oh, yeah.
Slovaks now get a power play opportunity, and this is probably Jay Mullen. Here's your answer. Whoever's in the penalty box the least, that's who's going to win.
Yeah, you're right.
Power plays in this. Very, very big. Slovaks. First power play. Pass in the slot. Nice check deck there by, I think that was Liebers. Not sure. Comes back to Kolar. Kolar on the left side. Plays tag with the defenseman up top. Kolar is not going to get a shot at that one. He'll take it down below the blue line to settle down. Cross floor pass. Finds the stick of Tika. Here's Tika. No. That's Rampacek. Rampacek. He's going to put it back to point to Kasir. Kasir to Rampacek. No shot yet from the Slovaks. Move it to the other side to Kolar. Kolar can't get it. Here's Rasir. Shot from Kolar. Nice pad saved by Rethage on that one. And the USA goalie looked calm, cool, and collected there. Nikki Kilcourse checking in. Shout out to Corey Wilson, also known as Mitz, and Matty Caron from the Leo Minster boys back home. Slovakia, 22 seconds remain in this power play. Marek Slovak on there now, back for Kasser. Here's a shot from the side. Nice save by Rethage on that one. Bobby Hauser out to kill the penalty. Hauser causes the turnover. Away goes Hauser. He's got Denny Schlegel joining with him. Not sure if that's what I'd want to see if I'm a Slovak defender right now, looking up at two of them. Here's Hauser in front. Great poke check by Stanislav Petrik off the stick of Hauser. Penalty is over. Americans on the attack. Hauser. He's pinned in on the boards. Hauser walks away. Here's Hauser. Backhand pass. That's an ill-advised play. And away comes Slovakia. That's probably the first bad pass I've seen Bobby Hauser make this week.
Yeah, I don't think that he thought that the Slovak player was there. I thought that he thought that was going to be an easy one to Schlegel.
Slovakia now, pressure down low in the American zone. Americans do a good job of clogging up the crease area. Here's Orovic. Orovic spins around, backhand. Orovic, he's a guy to watch for the Americans. The only player actually that I can compare to Bobby Hauser in this tournament as far as who protects the ball and handles the most, I think for my money, Boris Orovic and Bobby Hauser are the two best stick handlers in this tournament.
Something to be said for flexibility. The body, I mean, we're talking on the physical level. Both of these guys are incredibly flexible, where they can just create space because they're pushing outwards and they're 8 feet away from a guy. A guy can't even swing a stick at him because these guys are so flexible.
Bill Damiano checking in, telling me, don't forget I need to name my all-tournament team. And Bill, you know something? I am going to do that. It's probably going to be different than the one that's actually picked by the tournament committee, but I have absolutely nothing to do with that one.
Well, you can put 1,000 people in a room to pick the all-tournament team, and I bet you two of them are never alike.
But you will get the 2015 Steve Power Selects.
Oh, yeah. Looking forward to it.
Maybe I can send them a bottle of Newfoundland beer or one of my little Newfoundland Screech Mickeys as their official prize.
Oh, yeah.
And, folks, I'm crazy enough to do that, by the way. Greg Walsh checking in. Shout out to Petrik. I am a sofa king, whatever that means, but I guess Stanislav Petrik knows that one. Jessica Merchant going to give a shout out to the Americans, to Josh Merchant, as we get a chance to catch up on Twitter. Faceoff is going to be to the left of Petrik, just past this first halfway point. Now the United States going to get a chance to go to the power play as the ninja, Boris Orovic, is in the penalty box. Here's Hildreth with a drive. That one misses. Ruiz gives chase on the left side. Ruiz walks out, shot right on. Rebound. Petrik can't grab it, and he finally does. And right now, Chris, I don't know if you saw last night's Czech-Slovak game, but as tough as it is on the floor, to be honest, I think it's a little civil. Like in front of the net there, I thought you were taking life in your own hands last night going in front of the net.
Yeah.
It's a tough place to be right now, but it's not dirty.
Yeah, it was last night, it was pretty tough eating up in front of the net, but you got to be prepared for that. You know each other very well. You know what each brings to the table. When you have a situation like that, kind of got to expect it, I suppose.
Mike checking in, wanting to wish best of luck to Rick Zimek, a.k.a. The Stash. That's from Mike and Ed back home.
Pittsburgh.
Bobby Hauser digs in for this faceoff. From the draw, one cleanly. Here's a shot right on, and Petrick gets a piece of that one. Clock still running. I don't know if people realize the time. Now it's running back up, so I guess they realized it. There you go. Well done, clock timekeeper. Americans complaining about it, but in fact, they did catch it, and it ran down a few seconds, but then they did immediately ran it back up.
Yeah, they run it far enough back up.
I believe so.
Yeah.
I believe it was right on the money. CJ Dempsey checking in. Shout out to the Doherty family. Know they're watching and proud to be an American. Hashtag gold. And even if that hashtag becomes silver, I'm sure still going to be proud. This USA team has had a whale of a week here in Zug and have been the poster child for... That's one word. Professionalism is the best word I can put to it.
Discipline.
Discipline. Those guys are here for a reason, and it's to win the world championship.
No funny business.
Absolutely.
No late nights.
And there's been a few teams guilty of that, too.
Yeah, the coach Corey Hirsch and GM George Tarantino did a splendid job keeping the team having activities throughout the day when they had days off. Idle hands are a devil's workshop.
And if they can come out on this one tonight, sure there might be a few of those Budweisers you're talking about popped out.
Warm Budweisers, yes.
Robbie Calto checking in saying, get the ball to the assassin. If you're a fan of the red, white, and blue, that's certainly what you're looking for here.
Everybody knows who the assassin is there.
So still a fool up at the clock. I think they've got it perfect. Hildreth is just double checking. That's what captains do.
Yeah, I can guarantee he's probably lobbying for a couple seconds.
Oh, sure.
If he's not doing his job and put a C on somebody else's chest.
For sure. Crowd has certainly grown here. And I don't know who most people are cheering for, to be honest with you. I think that's going to be decided as the game goes on, Chris. I think people are going to find a favorite as it goes on. USA on the power play. Hildreth. Ball for Hauser. Hauser got Ruiz down on the left side. Hildreth over on the point, down for Ruiz, back for Hauser. Hauser shoots, scores! Bobby Hauser, not really known for the big shot back there. He's more of a disher, but Bobby Hauser lets it fly, and Petrick gets caught deep in his crease, and the Americans on the power play take the lead.
I think that was a screen by Jim Doherty. I believe it was Jim Doherty in front of the net. I don't think Petrick even saw him wind up for the shot.
I don't think so, nope.
No.
I'll tell you what, I really like what I see from the Americans. Going back to Jay Mullen, asking me for the call. I'm pretty close. I like what I'm seeing from the Americans now. I don't like Stanislav Petrick's body language whatsoever down in that net. But I tell you what, that guy, he's a cat. He's a goalie. He's different. He's a... We had a penalty shot last night in the Czech game, and as the guy was running into him, Petrick looked at him as if, who the hell do you think you are?
He may as well have said, do you know who I am?
Yeah, really, you can't be serious. You think you're going to score on me.
Right.
USA now back to work. Here's Sullivan. Sullivan in the slot. That one bounces away. Ball kept in at the blue line. Here's Haynes, short side. Chris Haynes almost got a gift. Off the boards there, and Atlanta, Georgia would have been going nuts if he had to put it home.
I think Atlanta, Georgia's going nuts already. They're big, big, big Chris Haynes fans down there. Ball hockey doesn't make its way down there too often, Steve, and they're very proud of him down there.
Kevin Cooley's asking me, I might want to change my mind about Hauser being the best player in the rink this week. Hey, he is one of the best. I'm not ready to anoint him still. The level of player in this tournament, wow.
Yeah.
Kevin, you have no idea. I've seen every game played here this week. And Bobby Hauser, no doubt, one of the best. Stay tuned for the Steve Power Selects to find out. Slovakia now. Rampicek down low, out into the slot, and Rethage is going to jump on that one. First time Rethage has touched the ball on the wall as the U.S. really turned it on here in this first period.
I wouldn't have it any other way, Steve.
The U.S. power play is lethal, says Jay Mullen, and you know something? They are. Bobby Hauser's power play goal, the difference right now. Greg Walsh check in. He says, let's be honest, Bobby's easily top 10 in the world. Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
Top 10?
Yeah, I know.
We're talking about
top 5 here, man.
Yeah, I might even be top 3, perhaps. He's really good. There's no doubt whatsoever. Yeah.
He's so composed.
Ball comes out in the neutral zone now. Slovakia. Martinisuk puts it down low. The American defenseman races back. We got a power play coming up again for the U.S. Here's Wilson had Schlegel at the net. Wilson had to get the Schlegel. That would have paid off more than a Vegas slot machine. Denny Schlegel from that angle. 5:01 left to go. The Americans going to go back to the power play. And this is a real big point in this game. This American machine, they can score a lot of goals, and they've shown it all week. But even tougher. It's tough to score against them, Chris.
Yeah, this is the biggest penalty kill that the Slovaks have had this week. There's no doubt about it. Because at this point, you absolutely do not want to go down 3-1, especially after the U.S. has brought in the last 5 or 6 minutes what they've been bringing, because if this continues.
Ed Rogers checking in saying Denny Schlegel is the best in the world. And we got Chris Curtis saying, regardless of the outcome, respect the Banks, George, and Corey for putting the team together right.
Thanks.
And that's pretty high praise.
Thank you,
there.
Chris.
And from my angle, being a Canadian and just being a ball hockey fan, you know something? I see how this team was put together. And you know something? They follow the blueprint. And if they didn't, the blueprint they come up with putting together is going to be robbed by a lot of coaches, and I'll be the first.
Yeah, I tell you, we had a plan from the very beginning.
U.S. Hauser shot, rebound, Ruiz. Couldn't get good wood on that one. He fires it over the top of the net. Back to the point, Schlegel for Hildreth. Hildreth down low for Ruiz. Ruiz cross floor for Hauser. Here's a shot by Schlegel. That one misses on the short side. Ruiz settles things down now. Ruiz shot right on. Doherty couldn't control that rebound. Doherty fires it back to Ruiz. Back to the point for the captain. Here's Ruiz's shot. Misses on the left side. Schlegel gives chase. Looks to Hildreth. Schlegel comes down. No, Doherty. Good job in front of the net by Doherty. Just couldn't get a stick on it. Doherty, not a big guy at all. He's standing in with those big oak trees from Slovakia. And he's taking a beating down there. But great job there by Doherty.
Coincidentally, Jim Doherty does that for a living. He takes down trees.
Wow.
I'm not kidding you.
Now, isn't that ironic?
Guy's not afraid to go anywhere.
Ruiz now up on top. Schlegel, a shot pass into the slot area. Ruiz knocks that one down. Here's Ruiz on the forehand. Ruiz shot, and Petrick steers that one aside. U.S. getting plenty of scoring opportunities on this power play. Stanislav Petrick shutting the door so far. Slovakia finally put the ball down the floor to relieve the pressure. Donovespi telling me, don't forget Coach Tom Ruiz.
Oh, yeah.
And there you go. Shout out to Tom. Banks, where are Denny's red sneakers? Patrick Burris wants to know.
You'd have to ask Denny.
Here comes the state shoot. Scores! What a move! What a move! Who was that, Chris?
Mike Colcourt,
the defenseman. Oh, my goodness. Stanislav Petrick. His jock just got put up in the flags here. Mike Colcourt, how are you doing today? Where does that come from? Mike Colcourt, stinky shoes, but sick hands.
Absolutely undressed.
U.S.
But
on the power play.
There's a lot of things I would call. I would have never called that one. What a move by Colcourt.
My goodness.
What a move.
Stanislav Petrick, a world-class goalie. He just got taken to school.
Wow.
So, Slovaks looking for an answer, and here's a chance. Right on, just missed. Slovakia almost with a quick answer right away. Here's Wilson now. Wilson back for Kaba. Kaba moves the ball behind the net for Zimek. Slovaks really getting aggressive here in this offensive zone this time. Rampacek behind the net now. Rampacek, here's a pass to the side. Nothing there though, gonna come back to the point. Big drive, rebound in front. Good job by the U.S. defenseman to clear it away. Take a breath here, Chris. You gotta say something, buddy. I'm starting to lose it. Wow, what action.
Starting to get speechless here, Steve. That what a pass. I believe that was Schlegel that fed Colcord. I think that's a Slovak. They weren't even paying attention to him because they didn't believe that he was going to run up as he did to the line, because he came all the way from his own zone and he just walked right in. And the move on Petrovic was unbelievable.
That was sick. That was wow.
That's the hands of a forward.
There's I thought it was Bobby Hauser.
So did I.
Took his body over or something.
Goodness gracious.
Slovakia right off the faceoff, throw one to the net. Can't get it down. Captain Colcord. Mike Colcord can do anything. He's like Erik Karlsson. He looked better than Erik Karlsson on that one. Looked more like Mario Lemieux.
Excellent. Excellent, excellent move. He absolutely undressed the goalie.
And Amanda Schlegel checks in. She tells us Denny's red sneakers broke mid-game yesterday.
That'll do
so
it.
There you go. There's the mystery of the red sneakers.
Well, I'll tell you what. I don't think it has anything to do with the sneakers.
Denny Schlegel could play in flip-flops and score.
I think he's already got a couple points in this game, and I don't think it has anything to do with the sneakers.
I think I said earlier the week, Chris, if I played on a line with Denny Schlegel, I might win the scoring race. And I'm 300 pounds and can't play. U.S. back to the attack. Slovakia going to need an answer here in this late period, but they definitely cannot give up another one.
No.
Whistle inside. We've got a pile up of bodies in the corner. Slovak player falls on the ball. Nothing new there, as they're always falling on it. 1:50 left to go. USA 3, Slovakia 1. Shout out again to Aiden Wabi, watching back in Canada. One of the very few guys maybe cheering for the ref today. Hope your birthday was great, big guy. 1:50 left to go here in the first period. Ryan checks in. That's Leo Minister, hockey talent for you. And wow, there's a pitcher, Chris Banks.
That's Doug. That's Doug Nickel back in the States. He's starting to warm up to Budweiser's.
Wow, Dougie, you might want to be careful with that one just yet. Nothing wrong with thinking about doing it though, but still a lot of time left to go.
A lot of time left.
Mike Colcord. Behind the net. Mike Colcord, long lead pass in the neutral zone. And the Americans, again, back to the attack. Ruiz down low for Gregory. Gregory. I would call this, is it safe to call this the second line for the States, Chris? Gregory, Ruiz, and Merchant?
Yeah, depending on the usage, depending on what you want.
I'll tell you what, I'm going to call it the best second line of the tournament.
The Sullivan, Haynes, and Hackett line, those two are pretty interchangeable.
Last minute of play, Slovak's now on the rush. Here's a drive by Marek Slovak, rebound there, good stick. Mike Colcord doing it at both ends, defensively and offensively, and he chips the ball out of play. Question for Chris, how many of the Pittsburgh gods are playing on this U.S. team?
Four, five? I gotta be close to five.
And Ed Rogers saying Denny only plays with Michael Jordan sneaks. Definitely a difference according to him. Ask him. Right now he's a little busy. So we'll leave that question for later. Just kidding with you, Ed. And Jay Mullen, believe it or not, Colcord was a goalie through high school. Oh, my goodness. A goalie scoring goals like that. Solid D-man. What's he going to do, make popcorn here next?
I know.
Here's Hauser. Hauser back for Hildreth. And I like this move by the American staff. Get the big guys on the end of period, especially.
Sure.
Got to have Hildreth out there.
Absolutely.
Here's Hauser down below.
Heck,
Hauser.
Better get Colcord out there.
Walks around. Yeah, really. Hauser, backhand shot. Petrick handles that one. All America this period. The Slovaks scoring very, very early. But since then, Team USA with 3 unanswered goals.
It's going to be interesting to see how they play this last 23 seconds, how they come out the second period, because you're right, Steve. Beginning of the game, they had some pressure in the U.S. zone, but it's been all USA.
Derek Kania checking in. like the compliment about the announcing, Darrington. Tell Banks to take notes. Not sure if that's a dig at you, Banksy, or not. But either way, actually, Banks is a buddy of mine now. He presented me with a USA ball hockey shirt yesterday, and I'm very, very appreciative of that. I will wear it back home in Canada, no doubt.
Excellent. At least they could do. To have somebody of your caliber here, Steve, calling these games, are you kidding me? It's the least we could do. Thank you.
So, after the first period, USA 3, Slovakia 1. Gold medal game 2015, ISBHF World Ball Hockey Championships. Hashtag the real deal. All right, folks, we're back for the second period. USA leads Slovakia by a score of 3-1. And to be hashtag Captain Obvious, the next goal is pretty big here.
I would say so, yeah. The next goal might be the one that defines what, or it's absolutely going to define what the rest of the game is going to look like for us. That's for sure.
B.A. Browntoe checking in. Banksy saying his feed is sucking there at work, so he's asking you to send him a few texts. I'll try play by play.
I'll try, Billy. The Americans are literally breaking the internet.
Yeah, this is
every time an American game comes on, the feed is crashing, and we apologize. And I know the Swiss committee didn't expect this kind of activity.
So, Alex Korza, Gazora, Alex, thanks for your kind words, big fella. And he's saying, Chris, thank you for your tremendous insight. Go USA.
Thank you, Alex.
All you American guys, you're going to be my buddy. I'm just telling you now, I'm going to be applying for the Canadian under 20 team as a coach for next year. And if I get it, I hate all of you. In the realm of sport hate, not real hate. USA ball hockey, no doubt, has turned the corner here. And I mean, listen, results speak for themselves.
They do. We've said this this week, where the United States has been participants in these tournaments. And it was time that we dusted everything off. Ricky LaPerriere made the commitment back at Milek and at Ashi to bring me on and bring all these great folks underneath me with it and turn this program around. And we owe everything to Ricky.
Slovakia with a chance there is Orvec, the ninja. He takes a wrist shot, and that one's held down by Rethich. Rethich looks, hasn't been tested very often, but looks very solid here, Chris.
Yeah, he, he's been the best player in the United States probably for a better part of the last year. He is absolutely dominant back home.
Ed Rogers checking in. A Pepsi, Metallica music in between periods, the sniper's ready. Sounds like my type of guy.
Yeah, that's Denny for you. He's known for his Pepsi. Hard to get Pepsi here in Switzerland.
I don't know. Jeez, I love Diet Pepsi.
Can't get it. I've been to 10 stores, can't find it. Somebody found some for Denny, though. I don't know where they got it.
Probably the same guy that brought the Molson Canadian for the Canadian team.
Well, the GM of my women's team said to me, hey, who's bringing us beer? I'm like, what are you talking about? He says, well, you know, the women got Molson Canadian. I'm like, well, I can guarantee they didn't get that in Switzerland.
No, sir. Bill Damiano, too bad, Steve. We like you. Dave Maltonero looking a bit upset.
Dave's a serious guy.
Nothing wrong with
wants
that.
Wants to win badly.
Here it goes. States on the short side, and Petrick comes across. Makes a big, big save there.
Not a lot of goalies are making that save. The release that Johnny Ruiz has, that play was, for those that watch hockey and know hockey, that play was a tremendous play.
That was a good save.
What a great save. Any other goalie that's 4-1 right now? Well, maybe a couple different goalies, maybe not, but we've seen some good ones this week.
That's one thing that's real. I mean, listen, the overall caliber of play has been fantastic, but the goaltending's been out of this world.
It's crazy.
Not just one. Like, I'll take your team, for example. Rethich and Rocha?
Yeah.
Wow!
People had asked me today, they said, do you go back to Jason Rocha? And, you know, there's a case for that, for sure. I mean, the way he played last night. But 9 days ago, Jonathan Rethich was the best player in the United States. How do you not go with John Rethich tonight? But then the question poses, how do you not go with Jason Rocha after last night?
Absolutely. There's no wrong answer there. What a great thing to have for a coach.
Oh, that's a great problem to have.
Slovakia now over the U.S. blue line. And this period starting off a little slower than the first. Really frenetic in the first period, though. Two goals in the first minute and 20 seconds.
Well, I think that I don't think the U.S. has changed anything. I think Slovakia has made some changes, and I think they've decided to slow the game down a little bit.
And that's probably not a bad idea.
Not a bad idea at all.
Good forecheck, back check by the Americans there. Petito puts the ball in. Hildreth tries to keep it down low. Battle for it along the wall. Here's a chance out front for Sullivan. Sullivan kicks it across the crease. Shot short side. Sullivan for the rebound. Once again, good stick check there by the Slovakian defenseman, Doskosil.
The U.S. is swarming the Slovakian
defense.
Here's
a chance in front for Sullivan. Sullivan couldn't get that one on. Petrik had the stick. Boy, I'm going to be honest. Right now, okay, Mullen, here's the call. I'm not seeing any of the Slovaks right now that can show me they're going to score three goals in this hockey game. So there's my call. You're looking for it, I give you the States. The American speed is just really causing a lot of trouble.
There's
two Slovaks defense.
Yeah, there's two on the ball every time, and the Slovaks are not adjusting to this.
Kaba puts that in. Petrick's going to move it himself. Kaba comes in, intercepts. Here's Kaba. He's got Schlegel going to the net. Ball comes out for Ruiz. Kaba shot. That's blocked. Kaba down low for Schlegel. Net's knocked off his moorings. There are no moorings, but the net is knocked off. Here's a backhand shot by Schlegel. Petrick's going to drop down. Hold on to that one. And Doherty, the diminutive U.S. forward, getting chased by a big Slovak defenseman there. Wasn't too happy with something that went down. USA drop Davkey. Not quite sure what that is.
You'd have to.
Twitter world is a.
You have to translate that.
I'm trying to do my translate. I couldn't translate it, so sorry, I couldn't get you there. Phelps Troba, Chris Banks has the voice of an angel. Well, Phelps, I tell you what, I'm going to have to not hang around with the people you're hanging around with if you think that sounds like an angel. Nice guy and all, gave me a shirt, but I got to stop it at that. Taylor Maltanero checks in. Yes, that is Dave's serious face. Here's a chance. Slovaks, Orvec, I thought he had a breakaway and he looked to pass.
He did look to pass. Why did you do that?
Here's Orvec, still with the ball on his stick. Orvec, very, very good at protecting the ball. Now it's swiped away by the U.S. out to the stick of Hauser. Hauser can't hold on to that one. Budak puts it down deep, but taken by Matt Caron. Taylor Molinaro, yes, that is Dave's serious face. I only actually see that face when he's playing hockey. So there you go. Ball goes all the way down the floor. No flooring on the play. The streets of Lemista will flow with warm Budweiser tonight in celebration. And, hey, still a little bit early, but certainly looks like it from now. Marek Slovak comes out over the blue line. Ball knocked out. Back to Slovak. Nice pass. Cross feed. Here's a chance alone in front. Big save there by Rethich. And Andrew Hildreth comes away. And that's the kind of goaltending you need to win a world championship, Chris Banks.
Absolutely. That's right. Rethich read the whole thing.
The best scoring chance since the first minute of the game for Slovakia. Here they are, all alone again. Marek Slovak turned away by Rethich. I don't know how they're getting these chances. That's something the States are going to want to tighten up.
Blue better tighten this up here. They're not going to get away with that all night.
Jonathan Rethich keeps the Slovaks off the board. Ball battles down low. Slovakia with pressure now. Ball's going to get put up over the glass. 7 minutes, 58 seconds remain in this second period. USA 3, Slovakia 1. Jonathan Rethich, as Bill Damiano says, it's his turn to make a statement. From the draw, and we're going to have a penalty right off the faceoff. American centerman slashed the Slovakian guy going for the ball. Milan Ledever was upended. And after a couple of nice chances, it looks like Slovakia's got some life here.
I think they called that on the draw, you know.
No, that's a good penalty.
You think so?
Yeah, absolutely.
I've seen that happen a lot this
week.
Yeah,
but it wasn't. He took two steps in towards the corner. He chopped him down pretty good.
All right.
I got to give him that one. And you know something? When you're up by two goals, it's easier to make that call.
Yeah, you're right.
If that's a one-goal game or team is down by two, maybe you let it go. But who knows what referees think? I don't understand stupid a lot. So here we go. Here's a drive from the point. Ladavir for Slovakia. The Slovaks, big power play early in this second period. Ball back to the point from Marek Slovak. Slovak puts one through. That one's deflected. The Slovaks are going to get another power play here. Referee's arm up. And Slovak's going to get a 5-on-3, and that is akin to suicide. I can't believe the Slovaks aren't giving them the ball here. And finally, they have the Americans touch the ball. Slashing call coming up, and USA trying to snatch defeat from the jaws of victory.
Yeah, this is not the way that they wanted to start this period, I'll tell you that. The Slovaks have all the momentum right now. They had a couple big scoring opportunities. Rethic came up huge, kept the score 3-1. Now 5-on-3. Gotta be careful. This thing's gonna get tied in a hurry.
So, 1:21 of 5-on-3 for Slovakia. And folks, this is the ball game here. Slovaks, it's still early, but they need to score on this one.
Yeah.
If the United States kill this, not just in terms of score, just in terms of momentum and getting a lift from killing the penalty.
Yeah.
So Slovakia on the power play, Martinisuk, and Slovakia will be the only team in this tournament that likes to attack from behind the net like this. They'll change the point of attack from high to low. Now they're low. Martinisuk now. The other side, here's a shot from the side, and that's the shot they look for off the big stick of Kassir.
Big body of Mike Colcord got in the way of that. It's a big block.
Slovakia, down low. Another shot, that one doesn't get through. Colcord gets a glove on it in the slot. Mirkin's got to be careful here, assuming the ball is out, and Bobby Hauser with a wonderful play there to turn the ball up the floor. Mirkin's relieved the pressure momentarily. Slovakia look to gain the zone. They do so. 25 seconds left in the first penalty to the U.S. Here's Marek Slovak. Slovakia down low. Behind the net now is Kolar. Kolar to the other side. There's a shot. Nice save by Rethic. And a big, big clear there for the U.S. down the floor. Second period two, Chris Banks, long line change there. Long Americans managed to get one fresh player out.
Long line change, Schlegel and Hauser stay out there. Hildreth is out there.
Bad news is only one line change. The good news is it was Andrew Hildreth. One penalty over. Americans have killed off the first one. Slovakia still on the power play. Ladavir down low, back to Ladavir now. Ladavir tries a shot. That one doesn't get through. Ball over to the half boards now. 20 seconds remain in the power play. Here's the Slovak shot. That one's whistle wide. Marek Slovak chases.
Speaking of that, they need a whistle, or they needed just what happened
and
right here.
And the ball's cleared out. Another American gets a chance to change. And the last one will go through. The United States have killed this 5-on-3 penalty. Unbelievable turn of events here. USA kill it off. And a flooring call. The other official actually waved it off. They should drop this one at center, Chris.
Yeah, I don't. The one that was that was in a better position.
They should drop this off at center. We'll see what happens here now.
They should talk.
Caroline McRae, shout out to the Pitt boys. And she says, hey, Banks, don't those uniforms look good?
Caroline McRae does many, many, many designs for the U.S. program. She does great stuff. She designed the jerseys.
I do think your jerseys are sharp. Yeah. I'd love to get one of those jerseys. They're sharp.
Yeah, I'll see what I can do. I happen to know a couple guys in the organization. See what I can do.
They're sharp. Doug Nickel, Chris Banks has the voice of an angel. Dot, dot, dot. That smoked for 20 years. That's more like a Dougie.
That's called a smoky voice.
There you go. The smoky smooth tones. And the officials are going to get it right.
They got it right. That's good.
Both of them got together, have a talk, and the face-off will be at center.
Well, hey, that's why they're reffing in this game. They're the best refs in the tournament so far. So, like, as long as they get it right.
From the draw, Americans back to even strength now. Andrew Hildreth, he puts the ball behind the net. Team USA now step out over the blue line. Chipped into the zone by Merchant. Here's Ruiz now. Ruiz, he's bumped off the ball. Slovakia swing it the other way. Orvec, he gets a chance to come away with it. Slovaks trying to sneak in behind the defenseman. Chance here, Slovak player, unfortunately, runs into the referee. It was Rimsky.
It's a great defensive play by the referee.
Yeah. Slovaks behind the net, trying to fool Rethich. Get something going here. And they try to bank one on the back. Nothing going there. Rethich won't fall for that.
They tried to do that little lacrosse play where you put it on top of your stick. Lucky you didn't get one in the mouth there.
5 minutes, 26 seconds remain in this second period. USA 3, Slovakia 1. No change in this second period. Scott Tarzi, shout out to Hildreth, leading by example. Absolutely, and he's done it all week, Scott. There's a reason why that young man has a C on his jersey for sure. Rethich looks to be in some discomfort down there, Chris. Mark DeGregorio shouting out to Corey Hirsch, saying, "Doing hashtag do it for brother Brett." And Amanda Schlegel sending us a picture there of everybody on the couch supporting Team USA, all in their United States shirts and apparel. So Jason Rethich here, Jonathan Rethich. I don't know if he's hurt, he just needs some water. It's very hot in here, Chris.
Yeah, I don't...
it's funny. Real quick story, when you guys played Portugal, remember Daniel Medeiros and the performance and the injury? Daniel Medeiros was not hurt at all.
No, he was dehydrated. He was seeing double.
He told me that night, and he promised me not to say anything to anybody, and I do. If players tell me something, I keep it in confidence. But now it is all said and done. A game play by the wily veteran Medeiros in that game. He almost stole that one.
Yes.
For Portugal.
No player has said anything about how hot it was down there, so I'm not aware.
Here's a chance Hauser or Haynes almost sent in. Haynes, nice play to take that pass onside. Slovakia now, counterattack in the neutral zone. Here come the Slovaks. We're going to have a penalty call here, I believe. Or is the ball just chipped into the bench? Ball's just chipped into the bench. 5:03 left to go, second period. USA lead, 3-1. Jessica Merchant sending me a photo and a big crowd getting together there in Rutland, Maryland.
Oh, yeah, Massachusetts.
Massachusetts, yeah,
Jessica,
Canadian folks.
I believe, is the sister of Josh Merchant.
Yep. That's great. Good crowd on hand. I hope you're enjoying the broadcast. I know you're enjoying the score. Ball chipped around by the U.S. Slovakia go back to be behind the net.
It's a relentless forecheck by the United States here.
And you know something? You got to think the Slovaks aren't used to that.
No.
The only teams that will forecheck like that literally are Canada and the U.S.
Yeah. They do not like that game. They want to possess. They want to pass. They want 60-foot passes. The U.S. is not letting them have anything.
Here's Slovak, Hrivnak. Hrivnak down low. Hrivnak behind the net. Slovakia really making a concerted effort to go behind the net with the ball. Hrivnak moves the ball to the half boards. No shot there. Kaba, nice defense there by Kaba to chip that one up into the glass. C.J. Dempsey. Chris Banks asked Dougie Nickel how many Budweiser he's had already. He's a beaut.
He hasn't had one warm one yet, I can tell you that. I don't know how many cold ones he's had, but he's not had a warm one yet. He's very particular about that.
King Stevie Slow Jams. The refs have been spot on all game. Great work, boys. Go Team USA. You know something? I agree. Refereeing in this tournament, is a few times you'll hear me chuckle about it, whatever. But very, very, very good in this tournament. I'm not sure the two referees of this one. I know one is Michael Wabi. Doing a great job.
Yeah, the best I've ever
seen. Don't tell anybody I said it because I don't like refs.
No, they've done great.
They really have.
They deserve everything, every credit they get.
So, Slovakia in the zone. Here's a shot from the slot by Kolar. Rebound off the boards. U.S. a little slow there. Slovakia with a little step in their jump. Jump in their step, so to say. And not very often do you see them beating the U.S. player to the ball. Here's Colcord now. Colcord going to settle it down. Moves it behind the net.
Oh,
Karen. And Slovakia all of a sudden sending up two forecheckers.
Slovak just got away with one. Denny Schlegel was pretty wide open for a breakaway there. And I don't think the defenseman saw him.
Man, but it's only Schlegel.
Yeah, it's only
All right,
I call him a 9 out of 10-er.
Yeah. Slovakia, shot from the point. That goes high and wide off the glass. Play continues. Slovakia now bringing the play to the U.S. a little. Colcord, pass for Hauser. That's intercepted. Orvec, here's a shot on goal. Just clicked wide. Orvec behind the net. Orvec trying to make something happen for Slovakia. Orvec, ball's poked off his stick. Back to the point for Rasser. Back for Orvec. Orvec. Down low, going to the other side. Big play there on the boards. Tough spot. Here's Orvec, comes out. What a goal by Boris Orvec, the Slovakian ninja. A fantastic individual effort, and all of a sudden, Slovakia are back into this one. The last few minutes, the Slovaks have been there.
What an incredible individual play by Orvec there. For those that were doubting on who's who, in terms of who are the best, that Orvec just made his case on why he's the best. What a play. Have to do a better job against a guy like him.
So, Boris Orvec with a huge goal. And you know something? He's been doing it all week for Slovakia. He is there, Bobby Hauser. 2:23, 2:33 left in this second period. And the Slovakian brass to my left are on their feet now. Brand new ball game now, Chris Banks.
Oh, yeah. Well, you said that next goal, how big that next goal is. We're going to see how the U.S. is going to answer now.
USA now to the attack in the slot area. Here's Gregory. I like this line for the U.S. Great choice.
Yeah.
Coming back with this line after a goal.
Have to get out of their own zone. They've been in their own zone far too long.
Ball across the floor for Zimek. Pass out front, almost found the stick of Ruiz. Ball just rolled away from him. Slovakia now on the attack. Here's Benietz. Benietz, long shot, that goes wide. Down low for Skulte. Skulte puts it behind the net for Benietz. Here's Slovak. Marek Slovak down low. Easily Slovak's best game of the tournament today. Slovak to Benietz in front. Skulte was there. American player gets behind. That's Hildreth, the defenseman Hildreth. What a run by Andrew Hildreth to try to break free. 1:35 left to go in the second period. Amy Iwant checking in. Nice picture of the lads from Buffalo watching the game. I can't keep up with Twitter. Robbie Calto asked me to ask you about your face-off prowess when you played.
Oh, that was probably the only thing I did good when I was a player. Man, I want to draw our two.
And Darsh checking in me, telling me the other
Thanks,
ref
Robbie.
Is Thomas Bahacek, and doing a great job, these officials today. Not as good as you, though, Darsh. Here to States. Chance there. U.S., good answer back on that goal, and we're going to have a penalty call.
I hope
Slovakia. Gonna go to the penalty box. U.S. really started to bring it there. Cody wants a shout out to Chris Banks, formerly known as Big Bird, for spending a day at the London airport with me.
Cody Swift, him and I had quite an experience. Had a little passport problems, expiration date problems. Me and Cody had a good day. We had a horrible day, but we had a good day together.
Derek Karen checking in. Boss asked me why I haven't got anything done today. He's got the game on two screens. So,
well, here's the U.S. chance to answer.
And Jess Hackett does indeed, according to King Stevie Slow Jams, Jess Hackett did a great job drawing that penalty.
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely. That's the energy line for the U.S. for sure. And not just an energy line with considerable skill.
Yeah, they can put the ball in the back of the net. Chessis had a great game.
So, big power play opportunity here for United States. Schlegel shoots. That one's put it aside by Patrick. Nice save there. Ruiz back for Hildreth. Hildreth down to Ruiz. Ruiz shot. That one doesn't get through. Blocked in front. Ruiz. He backs off for Schlegel. Down for Ruiz. Ruiz going to creep in over the blue line. Ruiz looking to get the pass on the back door. Can't find it. Goes down low for Hauser. Hauser. Doherty setting up shop in front of the net. Denny Schlegel looking to get open. Hauser back for Hildreth. Hildreth, he's going to move it for Ruiz. Ruiz in his wheelhouse. He can't get it. That hit a player in front. Ruiz down low. Doherty. Doherty can't get it through. Nice play by the Slovak defenseman. Blehut, Pavel Blehut. Here's a shot in the crease and
wow,
Panislav Svetrik reaches out and grabs hold of that one. That was a game saver there.
It sure was. Good motion by the U.S., good rotation. Nice job of the Slovaks keeping the U.S. outside, not giving them anything down low. They only had one chance down low, and the goaltender makes a save.
People from Labrador, Newfoundland, Labrador, Canada, tuning in.
I love it, talking
about their provincials coming up next week. I'm looking forward to seeing the Carroll Lake team play in provincials. A few of my Black Horse provincial team members on it, always looking for more. So great to see the guys from Labrador come down for provincials.
Ooh.
Glad you're enjoying the broadcast. Ball shot down the floor. Final seconds of this period. Nice play there by Rethage just to leave it. Florida State's maybe time for one shot. Hauser lays it there, and that's going to do it for the second period. So, Slovakia with a big goal in the second. They close the gap. All right, folks. Buckle up, grab a beverage, perhaps a snack, and if you have heart medication, keep it close by.
And we'll sell you the whole seat, but you're only going to need the edge for this one, Steve.
This is going to be a whale of a finish. Team USA going to start the third on the power play. They've got 30 seconds to work with. US 3, Slovakia 2, winner are the world champions. Here's Hildreth. Hildreth in the neutral zone. Gains the line to Ruiz, but Ruiz has it knocked off his stick. Goaltender Rethage shoots it all the way up himself. Ruiz takes it down low onto Stanislav Petrik's stick. Need to be careful there. Slovakia sending some bodies here with a purpose. That's going to do it for the penalty. Team's at even strength. Errant pass turned over by the Slovaks. Here's a chance out of the box. Fired wide by Ladivier. Here's Kolar. Kolar down for Rampacek. Rampacek spins around. Rampacek top of the slot, and that one's blocked by Schlegel. Schlegel to Ruiz. Nice little hand-eye coordination there by both players. Long pass down the floor. Slovaks gain the line. To the net, that's knocked out of the air by Liebers. Slovak player down behind, play continues. U.S. out into the neutral zone. They get the ball over the red line. Slovakia turn it back, go the other way. Here's Martinisuk. Martinisuk, he gets high-sticked. Gonna be a penalty here. And he did get clipped. I could see that one from up here. Sometimes these guys roll around like they're shot, but that just, one there, he got clipped.
Just a minute ago, before the play, one of the Slovak players was behind the net. He tripped over his own feet, and the bench yelled, hey!
Oh, yeah.
Wait. There was no U.S. player near him.
But unfortunately for the States, that one there, that was a pretty easy call to make. Chris Liebers is going to go to the box. So Slovakia going to go to the power play.
Well, we knew going in, these games are won on special teams, and whoever's got the better special teams, that includes the penalty kill as well. If you're a better killer than the other team's power play, you're going to prevail most of the time.
Muni Hamdani checking in. Huge third period coming up. Watching in Niagara and hashtag Warpig support.
Oh, yeah. Buffalo Fusion team goes up to Southern Ontario to play against Mooney and the boys up there in the War Pigs, Jason Capaldi.
So U.S. win the draw, and that's the way you start the penalty kill.
2 minutes for ice skating. Time 31-31.
Slovakia to the power play. Slovak's going to settle things down. One thing Slovakia does, they don't normally take bad shots on the power play. If the shot's not there, they generally don't try to force it through.
Yeah, they are very, very selective. They're very patient. They'll wait and they'll wait and they'll wait and they'll wait till you make a mistake. They're a very disciplined group on the power play, that's for sure.
Here's Marek Slovak at the point. That shot is right on. Rebound there. Rethic kicks that one out. Controlled by Budak. Budak to Slovak. Slovak drives. I didn't think Rethic saw that one, but he felt it, and he drops down and covers up.
Well, he's far enough out on the crease where if a shot comes in, and as long as it's not picking the corner, he's making the save. You know, as a goalie in a situation like that, you got a big screen in front, big shot coming in, make yourself big, get out on the angle, nobody there for a rebound.
Listen to the Slovak fans here, Chris, getting behind their team, wondering who people are cheering for. I can tell you, there's a rather large group to my right cheering for Slovakia.
Yeah.
I can hear them. Slovak's on the power play, backhand shot towards the net. That one's easily steered aside by Rethic. I'm gonna have to stand up, I can't see below. Here's a chance out in the slot. Big play there by the U.S. penalty killer. Come in and take the stick away from the Slovak player in the slot. Rampacek behind. Rampacek throws one through, that touches nobody, goes all the way across. Kolar, back to the point, back for Kolar. Kolar. Here's a chance for the States. Ruiz sent away. Ball rolls a little bit too far for him. He just fires a shot on the short side. Slovakia now regroup in the neutral zone. Aaron Pasto, and that's going to be put down the floor by the American defenseman Dave Montanaro. 15 seconds left to go in the American penalty. Tony, I'm butchering your name. Tony DG.
DiGiacomo.
DiGiacomo.
There you go.
Asked me the next Worlds. Tony, glad you asked. 2017, Pardubice, the Czech Republic, going to be the site of the next official World Ball Hockey Championships. Offside call here in Slovakia. The mayor of Pardubice here yesterday checking out how things were run and wanted to get his head around what the Czechs are going to do next time around. And looking forward to a great event in Pardubice in the Czech Republic. Chris Banks, I know you'll be there.
Oh, yeah.
And many of these U.S. players I would expect back. I can only hope to be a part of that.
Oh, yeah. And if I know the Czechs, and I know them a little bit, I would say that they're going to at least do it upright like this one's been done. They don't want to be one-up by anybody.
Jay Mullen checking in with me saying, am I still picking the U.S. or am I back on the fence? No, sir, Mr. Mullen. When I pick, I stay there. I'm going to stay with the States.
Attaboy, Steve.
Yeah, listen, it's not for you to be my buddy. Joseph Stumpel's right here to my left. I mean, call it like I see it. Mike checks in. Good luck, Rick Zimick from Colin, Dev, Mom and Dad. Slovak's good pressure here down low. Ball bounces out. Whoa! That one right by the net. And Rethic had to be careful there. Becoming a war zone down low, Chris. Referees seem to be trying to put the whistles away. Here's Hauser. Hauser coming in. Schlegel behind him, shot right on. And that's the first shot Petrick's had to stop in a while. Boris Orvech comes up. Here's Orvech. Orvech spins around. Rethic stares that one aside. Behind the net for Martinisuk. Out front. Good block there by the American defenseman. And the ball comes out.
The way this game is going, you're wondering if the U.S. team is taking the approach where bend but don't break. But boy, the Slovaks,
dangerous
approach.
Ball comes all the way around. Kept in momentarily by the Slovaks. Here's Roman Budak. Budak comes up with the ball. Budak down low, shot short side. Wow, hard angle there. That went through Rethic. And the Americans are lucky to escape there. Here's the ball behind the net. Slovakia with some immense pressure now. Slovaks pretty much owned the back half of that second period, and they've owned the beginning of this third. Team USA holding on. Here comes Slovakia. Nice move there by Beniaks. Beniaks comes in, shot. That one stared aside by Rethich. Slovakia, control in the American territory. Long shot, rebound in the slot. Rethich, what a great save on that one. Slovaks on the backhand. Rethich once again with the save. The Slovaks throwing everything but the kitchen sink at the American goaltender.
Actually, I think I saw the kitchen sink a second ago.
Tell you what, the Americans need to get this ball out. I can see a penalty call coming soon, but a nice play there to get it out for Kaba. Kaba, ball down low behind the net. They're going to force Patrick to hold on. 6:08 gone into this third period. The Slovaks on fire here. They are attacking the U.S. with serious malcontent.
U.S. has to make an adjustment. They have to be. They have to get it together. They have to. They're on pivots in their own zone.
To quote old Jim Ross from the WWE, this is starting to turn into a slobber knocker. Haley with the shout out from Texas. Sabrina Carson Haley going to shout out to Chris Haynes, wishing him well. Slovakia now. Here's Orvec. Orvec, easily the most dangerous Slovakian forward this game. He makes the feet first slide. He's going to go offside. Haven't seen many players slip, Chris. The floor must be holding up really good. Yeah. Really, really humid in this building.
Yeah, they said the players told me that maybe the first game the floor was just a touch slick, but it looks like it's good and worked in, and there's not any very little slipping going on. It's a nice floor.
Ball comes all the way down. Petrick makes the outlet pass to Blayhut. U.S. now in their own zone with control of the ball. Takes it behind the net, under pressure though. Nice move here by the U.S. defenseman to move it out. But it's stolen. Here's Orvec, in right on shot. And Rethich holds on, and the Slovaks, and this is what I talked about with you off camber, comparing Orvec to Hauser. If that's Bobby Hauser there, I'm sorry. They're dropping this one at center because there was a guy open in front.
Yeah.
Hauser would have seen him. Orvec, brilliant with the ball, good offensive player, just doesn't have that vision.
Orvec might be the most talented individual player in the world. You know, as an individual, he makes plays. You know, and the second goal, the second Slovak goal, was a testament to that. He made such an incredible individual play, but the head's down. You know, in all fairness, the head is down. On that play, same thing. Head was down, tried to tuck it in a place where it wasn't never going, and there was a guy open. Another Slovak player on the other side of him, a nice little tip-tap pass, game would have been tied.
So face-off is going to be in American territory to the right of Jonathan Rethich. From the draw, Pruitt hammers the ball around for Schlegel. Guys, a question, Chris. I'll tell you what, here's a long shot, rebound on the boards. Slovaks with a chance. Whoa, just missed over the top of the net. Slovakia really bringing it now. Another shot long off the boards. Here's Rampacek. Rampacek shot block. Rampacek second opportunity. Kolar in the slot. And Jonathan Rethich comes out and closes the door. Where is Corey Wilson? Chris, I haven't seen him in a while.
Well, I think that the line that has been dominating on the power play has been Bobby Hauser, Denny Schlegel, and Jonathan Ruiz. And I think that Corey Hirsch here is making an adjustment then to put Ruiz out there, because that line's
happen.
Been so dynamic.
Absolutely. Yeah. Close game late.
It's time to shorten up the bench here.
Halfway through the third period, floor tilted towards Jonathan Rethich now, with Slovakia pulling out all the stops. Here's the Slovaks behind the net. Good possession out front for Marek Slovak. There's a shot right on. And Rethich once again holds on. I don't know if they're going to beat this guy in the red, white, and blue, but the Slovaks certainly controlling the play for the last part of this game.
Little halfway through the third period here, and at this point, if you're the U.S., you're going to have to go back to fundamental hockey. Maybe take out of the repertoire the long passes. Start winning draws in your own zone. Start getting possession behind the net. Start making good, responsible passes, because the Slovaks seem to be intercepting everything that the U.S. is trying to do.
From the draw, shot for Slovakia, they score! It took a shot from the point, and I believe that was Josef Moranek. Rethich couldn't get set for that one as the shot was hit right away, and we've got a tie hockey game here.
All starts with the draw.
7 minutes left to play. 3-3 Slovakia and the USA. And Chris, you got to excuse me. I've got a smile on my face, and it's not because I want the Americans to lose, by all means. I'm just smiling because of the level of ball hockey being played here and the crowd. I know it's tough for you. I've got you on my right. I've got the Slovakian president, Joseph Stumpel, on my left. And I like both of you guys, so. But I tell you what, this is great for ball hockey. What a championship game here tonight.
And here is the third goal for Slovakia.
United States now try to get to the attack for the first time in a while. And away come the Slovaks. Orvec turns it over in the neutral zone. Back for the United States now. Here's a chance down low. U.S. on the backhand. That shot is stepped aside by Petrick.
That was Mike Colcourt again.
Here's USA in the corner. First time in a long time the U.S. with any sustained pressure in Slovakia territory. U.S. though doing a good job. They're making some line changes to get some fresh legs on the floor. Hackett calling for the ball. Down low is Haynes. Here's Haynes. Haynes, good strong move to the net. Haynes has shot right on. Petrick stops that one. Great save there by Petrick on a strong move by Chris Haynes. Here comes Orvec. Orvec can't beat Andrew Hildreth there. Hildreth shows some stick handling ability of his own. His shot goes in. Petrick, long pass out. Doherty can't stop Orvec. Orvec throws it to the net, and a nice save there by Zimek from the U.S. on defense. Here's Orvec. Orvec gets the shot off there. Rethich doesn't know where it is. Whistle blown. Take a breath. Wow. I don't know, but Chris Banks might be going for a smoke here in a minute. We're going to have a timeout. And Joseph Stumpel might join him outside. I might go, and I don't even smoke. Face off. Won by the Slovaks. Slovaks seem to be dominating in all facets now. Gotta wonder, is at any point in time the Americans think about a timeout here, Chris?
I think if there's any time to call it, might be now, Steve.
It just the floor is
to
tilted.
Slow it down, yeah.
Face-off in USA territory. Draw once again won by the Slovaks.
They're winning every one-on-one battle. They're winning every draw.
Here's a chance now for the States. They chip the ball out. Denny Schlegel up over the blue line. Looking for Ruiz going to the net. Ball chips out into the net area. Faceoff will go outside, I believe, or inside. No, it's going to be inside.
Inside, yeah.
It is going to be inside. Little energy line. Jess Hackett, Gregory, and Sullivan going to step over the boards for the States. Orvec takes a seat for Slovakia. Seen a lot of Boris Orvec this period.
Yeah, do you blame him?
No, sir. Tell you what, if the Slovaks take the lead, though, you won't see him no more.
Probably not.
Slovak coach, very good with managing personnel as well. Aside, as well as Hirsch. Colcourt. Backhand pass in the neutral zone. The Americans chip it into Slovakian territory. Slovak set up shot behind the net. Long pass for Marek Slovak. On the other side, Colcourt watches him. Here's Slovak's shot. He rips that one over the glass, over the net onto the glass. Colcourt now for the USA. Colcourt behind the net for Liebers. Liebers fires one around. The Slovaks making changes. Pick that one up. Skulte back to the point here for Slovakia. Slovakia traffic in front of the net. The Americans can't find an answer to the Slovaks right now. All momentum has changed. Slovakia, good move to the front of the net. And Hauser lucky there. That's the penalty we see all week, the slash and the stick. And Hauser makes a nice defensive play, but borderline penalty.
Yeah, I'm not sure they're calling it with 4 minutes to go.
No, that's, I tell you what, yeah. Referees are gonna str- try to put their whistles away, no doubt.
Yeah.
But we did see, hey, in the quarterfinal game, Canada got nailed for a penalty in overtime.
Sure did, yeah.
So it can happen. King Stevie slow jams. Amazing game. If it goes to overtime, will there be a Buick overtime challenge? Yeah. We'll call it the SVK Building Trust Talent Challenge here.
There you go.
So, U.S. trying to get to the attack. USA, Hauser. Nice drop pass to him by Schlegel. U.S. now big line on the floor in the offensive zone. First time in a while. There's a shot deflected in front. Ruiz almost got a stick on that one. Back for Hauser. Hauser's got Zimek going to the net. Zimek couldn't get a stick on that hot shot. Comes down low for Ruiz. Ruiz wraparound. Almost found the stick of Schlegel. Ball just bounces over Schlegel's stick. And here's Orvich. Orvich splits the D. Orvich on the backhand misses. The ninja all over the place for the Slovaks. Slovakia out front. Orvich shot right on once again. And Boris Orvich is taking this Slovakian team on his back right now.
He is absolutely unstoppable right now, Steve. There's nobody better on the floor right now. Maybe Jonathan Rethich.
Yeah. 3 minutes, 45 seconds left to go. Folks, I'm telling you what, I'm not playing. I'm sweating like a pig up here. It's just unbelievable, the warmth and the atmosphere in this building. How exciting is this? I'm willing to bet if Canada was playing, I'd be in the hospital for sure. Slovakia, back to the attack. Rampacek behind the net, under watchful eye of Montanaro. Rampacek still has the ball. Chased down by Liebers now. One thing the Slovaks do good, they throw those picks behind the net.
Oh, yeah.
Here's a shot. That one gets deflected in front, bounces harmlessly to the corner, but picked up by Martinisuk. Martinisuk. Ball out to the point for Kolar now. Kolar, he's going to put it cross corner. Slovaks make some changes. Slovakia doing a real good job making changes when they have the ball.
They're changing well. They're cycling well. Every loose ball seems to be popping right on a Slovak stick.
And there's something to be said, Chris, about experience at this world level. And the Slovaks have it.
They have everything. They've dominated the sport for the last couple of years.
Here's Sullivan now.
That's no accident.
Sullivan, outlet pass for Gregory. Gregory, he's got a step on the D. Gregory on the backhand. Petrick drops the paddle now, makes that save. Battled fourth down low. Marek Slovak takes it away for Slovakia. For Martinisuk, back for Slovak. Slovak at the blue line. He's going to turn that ball over, and Jess Hackett comes away for the States. Hackett over the blue line. Hackett shoots, fires one over the top of the net. And the goalie's going to hold it on for a faceoff. 2 minutes, 13 seconds left to go. Tom Logan, someone get Denny a Pepsi. My man needs it. Well, I tell you what, if there was any way Chris Banks could get a Pepsi to that bench, it would happen all the way from up here.
Guess who just walked out on the floor for Slovakia?
The ninja.
I'll give you two guesses, but you're only going to need one.
Yeah. I don't know if I'd have him out for the defensive zone
face-off. Maybe not for the defensive zone face-off.
Orvich with the ball on his stick.
I'll tell you, they're feeling pretty confident, so they've spent an awful lot of time in the U.S. zone.
Ball in the U.S. zone once again. Given chase by Madera, Lucas Madera. And there's the thing with the Slovaks. Haven't seen Lucas Madera today.
No.
Out here now in the final minutes. Slovak coach using his bench. Going to be a flooring call against the U.S. 1:45 left to go in this third period. You got to think, Chris, the U.S., I don't know, but I'd be... You get any chance to shoot, I'd be letting it go.
Probably.
Because Petrick hasn't been tested in a long time.
Get Denny Schlegel, Johnny Ruiz down by the net. Get some shots in, some rebounds.
Denny Schlegel by the net. I'd let him shoot it from the hotel. He got a chance of scoring from anywhere.
Yeah, that's true.
Here's a face-off right on the pick of Budak from the point. Slovaks off the draw. Dangerous. And they almost score once again right from the face-off. Yeah. Someone tweeting in, is Ninja Slovakian for don't pass? Probably is, but that's the guy's nickname, so I just go with it. Zimek fires it around. Ball goes down the floor. No flooring as the referee waves it off.
Slovak got away with a little interference there on Denny.
Well, that's nothing new.
No.
Here comes Slovakia. Titka moves the ball up to the blue line. Nice play there at the blue line by the American defenseman. Here's Hauser, the shot. Nice shot there, and that's a save by Petrick. Ball sent down the floor. Flooring call. The United States might have got a little break there.
They might
have. As the American defenseman gingerly jogged back for that one. So the Americans will get a face-off with a minute and 12 left in Slovakian territory. Still no timeout for either team.
Yeah, well, you know, you see Hauser, Ruiz, Schlegel out there.
Yep.
Old Hildreth, Zimek. I don't think you're going to see anybody
out
there.
That's what they want.
Yeah, at least for the third period, because they still got that timeout. They can catch a breather if they need it.
And the Slovaks with big number 41, Ivan Kocur, he's played a hell of a game for the Slovaks today on defense.
Oh, yeah.
He's been a rock for sure. From the draw, Hauser shoots. Oh, they had the chance there. Denny Schlegel just missed off the faceoff. What a quick shot. Petrick didn't have a chance. States with pressure. Ball lifted out in the neutral zone. Here's Slovak now. Slovak gains the blue line. Marek Slovak takes a shot, and Jonathan Rethage holds on to that one into the final minute of play. Denny Schlegel, inches, just inches.
Denny doesn't miss those very often. I'll tell
and
you that.
It was so quick off the faceoff. So faceoffs, unbelievably important now. You see both teams make changes. Bill Sullivan going to dig in for the U.S. on the draw. And I believe he's going to line up against, it's going to be Lucas Madeira again.
I don't think Lucas Madeira's lost the draw today. There's another one.
Face-off, one by the Slovaks. Ball out, oh my goodness, Slovakian player almost had a chance in front. Gregory now for Sullivan. Sullivan back for Gregory. Gregory tries to chip it by the Slovak defenseman, can't do so. Now they gain the zone. United States, Sullivan, he gloves that ahead. That's not a real good play. They're better off letting the Slovaks take that. Sullivan comes in and gets it himself, turns a bad play into a good one. Here's Schlegel. Schlegel tries to battle on the outside. Schlegel spins away from his man. Back to the point for Hildreth. Hildreth drive, rebound, short side. Hauser's behind the net. 5 seconds remain. Hauser in the backhand. He just missed. And the time is going to run out. And it's overtime for this one. The World Championship going to be decided in overtime. Folks, I hope it's decided in overtime, not in a shootout. Habs fan 27-31 telling me the finals is a 15-minute overtime. I honestly have no idea, so I'll say you're right. If it gets past 10, it keeps going. You're right. If not, oh well. That's the worst thing happens. You're okay. U.S. now. Here's a chance in the slot. Schlegel with the ball on his stick. He misses wide. U.S. right off the bat down low. Ball sent down the floor. Slovakia, good job on the forecheck. Hildreth battles down low with Schulte. America trying to come away with it. It's Hildreth. Hildreth leaves the ball around. Good forecheck here by the Slovaks. Sending all players. Moranic picks the ball up. Moranic back out to Kocur. Kocur hammers the ball around. Zimek takes it for the States. Zimek knocks it out. Schlegel can't clear it. Here's Titka. Long shot. That goes wide. Slovaks in the attack. They've got a line change in. The Americans are caught out there. Here's Beniaks. Beniaks behind the net. Beniaks takes a bump from Zimek. Ball in the feet on the board. Schlegel with a chance to clear, and he does so. U.S. need to get off the floor. 4 to 5 U.S. players change. Smart play there by Schlegel to stay
out.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, he wanted to come off.
He was
going
to go, too.
And if he would have, that guy would have been wide open up on the blue line there. Great play, Denny.
All right. So, folks, settling down again. I got to take a breath. Oh, my goodness. This is crazy. Fantastic action this 2015 ISBHF gold medal game. Going to be decided in extra time. Slovakia down behind the net. Rimsky does a good job protecting. Here's Rimsky. Liebers tries to knock it off his stick. Battle in front of net between Montanaro and Orvec. Rimsky down low. Good job here by the States, just keeping men to the outside. Orvec with the ball on his stick. Orvec to wrap around. Goes right through the crease. Nothing happening there. Hackett, chance to clear. Nice effort there by the States. Here's Chris Haynes. Haynes comes down, gonna wait. He throws a ball out. Probably should have threw behind the net there. Yeah. He's changed. Teammates a chance to change. Nice shot by Doherty there. That one stared aside by Petrick. Ball comes back to the point. High slot at the blue line. Doherty's shot. That one whistles high and wide. And Slovakia, chance to take over. It's Danko. Danko waits for his mates to change. Ball passed over for Filip Tika. Tika behind the net. Tika over for Danko. Now we got Roman Budak on the floor for Slovakia. That pass misses everyone, goes all the way down. And flooring will be the call. Swiggy checking in, telling me 1:15 minute overtime in the final, then the shootout. And I believe Swiggy, if I believe anybody. Amanda Schlegel's asking Banksy, what's the number 24 in the U.S. helmets for?
That is in honor of a player that we lost too early a couple of years ago by the name of Tyson LaJoy from the Massachusetts area. Hard to even talk about. Yeah, one of the best kids ever.
Always,
you know,
tough.
I mean, did he not have a smile on his face. Everybody in the country liked him.
Always tough, and that's a big honor anytime you see something like that.
He's very, very missed. He's missed by so many people.
You don't have to talk to me about that. I feel in this hockey world, whether it be ball hockey, ice hockey, you know something, we don't. Yeah, there's differences of opinion, and we fight about stuff and everything, but everybody loves the game, and everybody does their best.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, you know something, we honor people when they're dead, and that bothers me.
Yeah.
I mean, there's so many times, there's so many people around to do such great things for the game, and we should be doing more to honor them and work with each other. And in this ball hockey world, as we all know, there's a lot of strife out there.
Yeah.
Guys, let's just try to figure out what an event we got going here.
Well, I tell you what, wherever Tyson is, he's looking down and he's smiling down on us. He'd be here. he's here. I feel it. He's here already. He's a great guy.
Big moment in USA ball hockey, kid like that.
Damiano.
The stream is the worst it's been all tournament. It's the people logging in, Bill. They can only handle so much. Corey T says we are breaking the internet. Yeah, might be my voice breaking it too. I'd say Schwiggy's back in BC getting a good laugh at me.
Yeah.
From the draw, the Slovaks tried to come out. Gregory keeps it in. Gregory with a long shot. Merchant can't get a hold of that one. Here come the Slovaks. Long pass for Kolar. Kolar can't get to that one. Hildreth is going to fire it all the way around. And the U.S. with a chance to come away. Doherty tries to shovel it to the net. Gets there. Here's Doherty now. Nice defensive play there by Budak.
Get it deep, Jim.
Jimmy Doherty coming out. Doherty, nice toe drag move there. Almost got there. Looking for a penalty call, and that ain't going to happen on a play like that. I think you're going to have to be bleeding, shot, or really, I mean, you got to. You would hope the penalty's going to be a really, you know, for a call.
There's
there.
More of a, Jim, there was more of a chance of the referee calling a penalty on you or I there. Than
absolutely,
it was
more
there.
Chance of me losing 50 pounds. I can tell you, that ain't happening. So, face-off is going to be to the left of Stanislav Petrik.
There it is.
From the draw, U.S. win the face-off. Ball comes all the way down the floor. Liebers has got to give chase.
Great job by Bobby Hauser, giving Denny another shot at that. Same shot that he had before that time. Great block by the Slovak.
Ruiz step around Kasser. Ruiz gets the ball down low. Ruiz throws it out front. And Petrik, calm and cool, just knocks it back.
Then he whacked that out of the
Hauser.
Air.
Hauser looking for Schlegel. Schlegel spins free, shot right out, rebound. Ruiz in the slot. He just missed. The United States big line doing what they're supposed to, but Stanislav Petrík shuts the door. It's going to take a hell of a shot to beat one of these goalies here now. Thanks a lot, King Stevie Slow Jams. I love the Twitter handle, King Stevie Slow Jams.
That's great.
That is great. The U.S. going to make a line change. Slovaks leave the Ninja and his partners out there. Whether you like Orvec or not, you just got to admit, for a guy who can handle the ball, Ninja's a pretty good nickname.
Yeah, it's a great nickname.
Here's Haynes. Haynes tries to spin away from his checker. Haynes brings the ball down low. Haynes does a great job of protecting that ball. Haynes down behind the net, chips it out. Here's a chance, ball loose in front, and the American player, Hackett, just barreled in to Petrík. But in Hackett's defense, he's coming out from behind the net.
He got a little help.
So how can you run the goalie when you're coming from behind the net?
Right.
Faceoff probably going to be outside, though.
I think he pointed inside to the circle. But
yeah?
Yeah.
Wow.
I think so.
The defender.
I don't know, Chris, if that faceoff's inside. I think you did well there.
Well, hey, the defender basically
I don't think the defender had anything to do with Hackett going into that goalie.
Well, you know what? All I care about is faceoffs inside.
There you go.
Right or not.
So, faceoff. Bobby Hauser on the draw. Faceoff won by Kolar. Kolar flips one high. Slovak's just running for the, I think, Ben Roethlisberger out there throwing the bomb. Slovak's ran themselves offsides. Liebers. Pass up the wall. Flooring waved off. U.S. get to it. Ruiz down low. He can't pick it up. Ball bounces into the high slot. And away comes Slovakia. Here's Rampacek. Rampacek for Kasser. Kasser with the shot. Short side. Another shot right on net. And Rethich had to be careful with that one. No such thing as a bad shot in overtime. Here's Hauser. Hauser coming in. Got Schlegel with him. Hauser, great defensive play there by Roman Budak for Slovakia. Marek Slovak, he squirts free. Slovak can't get a shot off there as Kolkord does a nice job defensively to stop him. Here's Haynes. Haynes, Jess Hackett has to go back out onside. Americans got to clear the zone, and they do. Slovakia, chance to clear, but good forecheck there by the Americans. Sullivan for Hackett. Hackett got some traffic in front, throws it behind for Chris Haynes. Haynes spins away. He tries to get the shot through. Jet just missed on the far side. And Slovakia put the ball down the floor. Kolkord, Hackett looking for the ball in the middle. Kolkord, pass for Doherty. Doherty, Americans really starting to step it up here in this overtime. Doherty couldn't get to that one. Now it comes out in the neutral zone for Slovak. Slovak throws one to the net. Doesn't get through. Americans can't get the ball out. Now a second chance, and here's Gregory. Gregory chips it by. Nice defensive play there by Blayhood of Slovakia. Americans controlling the ball. Gregory brings it all the way to the red line. Gregory shot, that's blocked. And Rethich is gonna play it out for Gregory. Gregory's too tired to go back and get it. Gregory, pass, nice pass too, finds Hildreth. Here's Hildreth. Gregory upended. Hildreth's going to keep it in. Good play by the American captain. Slovakian defenseman knocks it down. Pass up the floor. Finds Orvec. Orvec tries to walk through. Can't quite get it there. Here comes Wilson. Corey Wilson now getting a shift here in overtime. Wilson shot. Petrík goes out. Plays that one himself all the way down the floor. Orvec with a chance. Orvec one-on-one with Liebers. Liebers keeps him to the outside. Orvec spins, can't get the shot through. Here comes the Slovaks on the slide. Shot out a slot, and I think Rethich got a piece of that one. Orvec, Slovakia threatening here in overtime. Here's Orvec. Nice play there by Corey Wilson to pick his pocket. Ball across for Hauser. Hauser's got Schlegel coming through. Schlegel's molested at the blue line. Here's Hauser, shoots, what a save by Patrick Dare on the block. Hauser had the corner picked. Back to the point. In the slot, Ruiz all alone, shoving up, big glove save there by Patrick, and away come the Slovaks. Glorious scoring opportunities for the USA. Here's Rampacek, Rampacek shot, that's blocked. Other side, another shot blocked. Hauser now for the States. Bobby Hauser gonna stop, settle things down. Oh my goodness, folks, great chances. Great chances. Hildreth gonna take the ball behind the net. Settles things down, both teams making changes. Hildreth waiting for something to happen. Slovak player content just to wait him out. Slovakia, good man-to-man coverage. Long pass, Hildreth in the neutral zone, looking for Doherty. Offside's the call. I thought that was offside. A pretty good pass. That, you know something, I think the referee sort of got out of position there. He got caught.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, why are they calling it all 15, the way down?
Yeah, that's where the pass came from.
Oh, yeah.
It's
going
to be offside. That's where it's got to be. 15 minutes is this overtime. Just confirmed it on the loudspeaker PA system here. Wow. I got to take a breath, folks. I don't even have anything to drink here. Drinking water like a fish. I might take a shot of rum now if it was around, I tell you that.
If the folks at home could see the setup here up in the booth, it would appear that Steve's drinking water like a porpoise over here.
Looks like I'm homeless up here too, I think. People might think I'm homeless. I've been here all week. Face-off won by the United States. Merchant brings it over to blue line. Merchant, good idea if he gets it deep. Can't do so. Marek Slovak intercepts, moves it over for Rivnak. Rivnak for Slovakia. Rivnak down low, he takes a bump. Rivnak, chance to come around though. Chased down by Zimek. Rivnak got position, Zimek's gotta be careful there.
Well, I don't know, they haven't called anything, so why would they start now?
Here's a chance to shoot in the slot, Slovak. Not going to shoot.
Good play, Josh
Merchant.
And a Merchant.
Great play by Josh Merchant to intercept that one. Merchant's got Hauser going to the net. And Petrick's going to hold on to that one for a faceoff. King Stevie slow jam. Somebody get Steve Power. Pepsi, you are correct, sir.
Stevie slow jam, if we could find Pepsi in this country.
Yeah. Yeah, there's not much Pepsi here, buddy. Sort of a Coke only. All right, listen. I'm okay. Derek Kenya, come on, man, with the Roethlisberger reference. Listen, I'm not a football fan. My team's the Lions, so I'll throw Matt Stafford out there. How about that? From the draw, Americans win the faceoff. Back to the point, shot by Liebers. That one's deflected high. Everybody looking for it. Ruiz finds it, bounces out in front, and Petrick comes out shaking his head. No, 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 says Petrick. Do the face-off all over again to the right of Petrick. Hauser been very good on face-offs, especially in this offensive zone.
Yeah.
From the draw, Hauser wins another one. Ruiz backhand shot, just threw it over the top of the net. Quick hands by Johnny Ruiz there.
Boy, they sure are getting opportunities.
Here comes Orvec. Orvec. Almost with a two-on-one to the net, and Rethich holds on to that one. Nice play there by Mike Colcord to make sure the rebound isn't there. That's funny. Colcord bumps the Slovakian player away from the net. And the Slovak turns to the referee. Like, are you kidding me? What do you want him to knit him a sweater?
Right.
Lord God, boys.
I'm not sure if it's the... You know, there's a lot of complaints about this back in the States. You know, that kind of... I'm not sure if it's a soccer culture or what, you know, what it is.
That's so silly. All right, from the draw, from the point, shot, that's blocked. Big shot blocked there by the American player. Here's a chance for the Slovaks. Another shot blocked in the high slot. Pass thrown across, no one there. Rampacek just threw it.
Those are dangerous.
Back
to
the point for Blejhut. Blejhut moves it across, kept in at the red line by Danko. Danko takes a shot, that's blocked. Ball down deep into the corner. Rampacek tries to come around. Molinaro does a good job. And Hildreth Clears the rebound in front of net. Hildreth,
ball.
High ball there. That's a great ball. Not far enough for flooring, making Danko go back and get it. Woo. Slovaks going to hold the ball on while their forwards change. Folks, there's 4 minutes, 15 seconds left, and I'm going to say it again. I really hope someone scores in these 4 minutes. I really don't like the shootout, and that's a personal thing. Nothing to do with the ISBHF or Canadian ball hockey. That's just me, Steve Power. I don't like the shootout.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of it either, Steve. Let hockey figure hockey out.
Yeah, here's Wilson. Wilson, pass for Haynes. Haynes chips that by. Moranek goes back and gives chase for the Slovaks.
Prelims for sure.
Yeah, I got no problem there.
Even quarters, maybe. Maybe.
No way.
Well,
no way.
I don't like it either, but I mean, no. If there's going to be a compromise.
If it's a winner, go home, I don't like it. Here's a Slovak shot, and that one's steered aside. Jonathan Rethich with his first big save in a while. And got to comment on the composure. And hey, listen, these guys might be frightened to death down there. I don't know. But from up here, they look as cool as cucumbers down in net. Patrick. I don't even know if Petrick realizes he's in a gold medal game.
I know.
That guy's in a different world altogether.
He took 3-4 shots. The guy was cooler than a polar bear's toenail, Steve.
Yeah. I like that. That's pretty good. I like to say he's slick as whale poop in an ice floe. But
there you go. I'd tell you what my grandfather used to say when it came to whale poop, but
another time.
Another time.
So, face off. One by the Slovaks. Here's a chance. Shoot. They score. It's Horvich with the deflection. A one face-off. Wrist shot goes to the net, and Boris Horvich, the ninja, has won the world championship once again for Slovakia. Team USA go down, and Horvich, if he's not player of the game, I don't know who is. Slovakia, the 2015 World Ball Hockey Champions. What a hockey game. Both teams, congratulations, Chris Banks. Thanks for joining us, buddy. You go down and be with your team. 3:31 left to go in overtime. Horvich gets the winning goal. Well, it's always sudden in overtime, folks. The shorties, American players feel like their hearts just got ripped out of them. The Slovaks in celebration. What a hockey game. No reason for the United States to hold their heads there. And you got to give Slovakia full marks to come back and show some real resiliency there. Wow. I'm going to leave the mics on for the medal presentations. And I'm just going to come back in about 30 seconds, and I'll give you the Steve Power selects before the tournament All-Star team is read out. Just got to take a break for a second, folks. Catch my breath. I'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, what an amazing final game of the Street Hockey World Championship 2015 here in Zug. Sika Building Trust, and the main sponsor of this World Championship 2015, presents the best players of this final game. These awards will be handed over by Mr. Josef Štilpo, the president of the Slovakian Street Hockey Association, and his friend Chris Banks, the president of the United States Street Hockey Association. Sika presents the best player of Team USA, number 88, Chris Hines.
So the player of the game for the United States, Chris Hines, is going to get the nod. He had a great game, good choice there. First medal ever for USA ball hockey in this event. So certainly nothing to hang their heads about. Player of the game for the Slovakians now.
Slovakia, number 77.
And Boris Horvich gets the player of the game. So while we're waiting for the official awards, I'm gonna give you my unofficial one. Steve Power selects my tournament all-star team. And hey, you can comment on it. I could be out to lunch. Who knows? It's my opinion. I've seen every team play a lot. And if I was going to pick two defensemen, three forwards, and a goalie to be in my starting lineup from this event, here's the way I see it. In net, I'd be taking the Slovak goalie, Stanislav Petrík.
Ladies and gentlemen,
he'd be my goaltender. On the fence from the Czech Republic, I'd be taking Thomas Kadela. From Greece, Danny Novas would be my two defensemen, Kadela and Novas. And up front, my tournament all-stars up front forwards, Boris Horvich from Slovakia, along with Denny Schlegel and Bobby Hauser from the U.S. So there you have it. I'm going to sign off. Congratulations to Slovakia 2015 World Ball Hockey Championships. I'm Steve Power. Thanks for watching.
Dear Street Hockey friends from all over the world, we just had the Street Hockey World Championship 2015 here in Zug, and a tournament of this size would never be possible without helping hands in the background, visible or invisible. We would friendly ask you to give a big hand to most of the 50 volunteers which worked for this tournament in the last 10 days. Please welcome all the volunteers. Ladies and gentlemen, as I said, all this tournament stuff would not have been possible without all these helping hands. Everyone has to be left up to a podest, but one of them has to be named especially. We name the thanks very much for the transport minister, the one who had all to do for the transport of the teams, of the materials, and so on. Big hand for Volunteer of the Year, Matthias Böhm. Gets the gold award for